Welcome to Smarter Everyday Overlearning. Dear students, how are you all? I hope you are all doing good. Today's our session is about the preparation of your NEET. And those who are preparing for NEET, this class is helpful to you. And students, up to now, for the preparation of the NEET from the chapter 1, that is some basic concepts of chemistry, some solved examples I explained in my classes. Then who did not go through that videos, that classes, I'll give that link in the description box. You can go through them. And students, now in this class, I am going to explain some solved examples from the atomic structure, the chapter 2 atomic structure. Some solved examples I'll explain you. This class is helpful to you for your NEET. And students, I think the NEET date is announced. That will be in the coming September. So students, this class and my further upcoming class is also very helpful to you. And those who are seeing the first time my class, those you can subscribe to this channel for my further updates. Dear students, without doing any late, let's start out today's session with some solved examples from the chemistry atomic structure. Thank you. Okay students, we'll start out today's session with the first question from the structure of atom and from the atomic structure. And see, if you see the question students, that first one is 4d5p, 5f and 6p orbitals are arranged in the order of decreasing energy. The correct option is, and this question completely from the Euler chart, that is basing upon the increasing energy of the orbitals and the decreasing energies of the orbitals. If you see the options, option A, 5f, 6p and 4d5p with the greater than symbols. 5f and 6p greater than 4d greater than 5p and 5f greater than 6p greater than 5p greater than 4d, and the last one is none of the above. Then this question basing upon the Euler chart, if you see the Euler chart diagram, filling order of atomic orbitals, Euler chart students, if you see the numbers n 1 to 7 1 to 8, these are the orbits, the first orbit, second orbit, third and up to 8 orbits. And this diagram shows the increasing value of n plus 1, ascending order, energies of various atomic orbitals. And here, this n indicates the principal quantum number, the main shell. And here, n indicates the azimuthal quantum number, nothing but subshells, SPDF subshells. Okay, students, basing upon this, if you see the energy levels, 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d energy levels, you can see here. And we are, if you are seeing the options, which one will be correct, let us select. Higher the value of n plus l for an orbital, higher is its energy. However, if two different types of orbitals having the same value of n plus l, the orbitals with lower value of n has lower energy. Therefore, the decreasing order of energy of the given orbitals, it must be C, that is 5f greater than 6p greater than 5p greater than 4d. This is the correct option basing upon n plus l value. See students, just I have written all the questions before, it seems, for just time saving. Let's start the second question. Which of the following series of transitions in the spectrum of hydrogen atoms falls in visible region? For these students, you have to see electronic transitions producing different series in the hydrogen spectrum. Okay, students, you can see here the different series, the Lehmann series, Balmer series, Paschen series and the bracket series and infrared series. Infrared, that is P front series. Okay students, and if you see the Lehmann series, it must be present in ultraviolet region, and this is visible region. And then third one is infrared region, and bracket series also in infrared region, and P front series also in the infrared region. And if you see the question, which of the following series of transitions in the spectrum of hydrogen atoms falls in visible region? And the options what we are having, the bracket series, I told you, that is the bracket series in IR region, and the Lehman series in UV region and the Balmer series which is in visible region and Pastion series which is in IR, infrared region. So students, for visible regions, that means Balmer series, you can select this option. So option C is the correct one. Okay, and let's start the third question. Orbital having three angular nodes and three total nodes is, and the orbitals they have given as options 5p, 3d, 4f and 6d. Which one is correct? Let's see. Number of spherical or radical nodes in any orbital is equal to n minus l minus 1. And students, number of planar or angular, planar or angular nodes in the orbital l is equal to 3. Therefore, the total number of nodes in any orbital is equal to n minus 1, that is 3. Therefore, n is equal to 4. Thus, the orbital is 4f orbital. If you see this tabular form, here SPD of subshells, for these subshells I have given the L values 0, 1, 2, 3. Here we got in the answer N value is 4 and L value is 3 here. For L is equal to 3, then that subshell is F. Basing upon this, we can select the answer here, that is 4F. Let's see the solution for the fourth question. In hydrogen atom, the de Broglie wave equation and the de Broglie wavelength, sorry, for an electron in the second Bohr orbit is, and the given that Bohr's radius A naught is equal to 52.9 pm, that means picometer, and we have to calculate for the hydrogen atom the de Broglie's wavelength of an electron which is present in second orbit, students. And let's see the answer for this. What they have given for the Bohr's radius they have given, that is A naught is equal to 52.9 picometer, they have given. And in the question itself, N value they have given that N is equal to 2. Why? Because that is in second orbit. So for this, the radius Rn, if you take n square, and for A naught is equal to 4 into 52.9 picometer, you can take like this. Why? Because already n they have given. If it is n square, that number will be 4 here, and the answer is 0.6211.6 picometers. And see the answer here, option B is the correct answer for this question. Let's start. And here see students, the angular momentum of an electron in a given stationary state can be expressed in this equation. For that is MVR, angular momentum. The equation will be H by 2 pi. That means here n is 2 into h by 2 pi is equal to h by pi. Here students, de Broglie's equation mvr pi is equal to h, and for the wavelength lambda is equal to h by mv, and lambda mv is equal to h. From the equation, these two equations, lambda value also we can get like this, 211.6 pi picometers. Okay students, this everything calculation is no need, for if you do this type of simple calculation, you will get the answer like this. You can select from the options, option B. Let's start the next one, number 5. Here students, three options they have given. In these, which one is wrong statement, we have to find out. Which one is wrong statement? Let's see the options here. Total orbital angular momentum of electron is s orbital is 0. This is correct only. And an orbital is designated by 3 quantum numbers, while an electron in an atom is designated by 4 quantum numbers. Because only for orbital, three quantum numbers, that is excluding spin quantum number. Here, an atom is designated by the four quantum numbers, that is including with the spin quantum number. So, this is also correct statement. And see, students, if you see the option C, the electronic configuration of nitrogen atom is, you know that, let us see whether it is correct or not. Nitrogen atomic number 7, and if you write the electronic configuration for this, 1s2, 2s2, 2p3, sorry, 2p3, and in this 1s2, 2s2, 2 electrons with opposite spins, and 2p3, see students, if it is spins, if you observe the spins here, according to the Hund's rule, the maximum, this notation is not satisfies that Hund's rule. According to Hund's rule, the maximum multiplicity, the correct configuration will be here, these three electrons must have the opposite spin like this. So the wrong statement is option C. Question number 6. How many electrons can fit in the orbital for which n is equal to 3 and l is equal to 1? So for these students, you have to see that tabular form for the subshells SPDF, and for the L values 0, 1, 2, 3. These are the L values. For suppose n is equal to 3, L is equal to 1. That means L is equal to 1. These are the L values, that must be P orbital. P orbital, okay. And for the P orbital, for the P subshell, they are 3 orbitals are there degenerating, and those are 3px and 3py and pz. Sorry, px, py, pz. These three are the orbitals for p subshell. And here, students, each px orbital must contain two electrons like this and like this. Okay, if you see full P orbital, there are 6 electrons. If you see only one single orbital, that is px, that must 2 electrons. For n is equal to 3 and l is equal to 1, the subshell is 3p, and a particular 3p orbital can accommodate only 2 electrons. Then the answer is option A, 2 electrons. Okay, students. And let's start the seventh one. The two electrons occupying the same orbital are distinguished by. The two electrons which occupying the same orbital are distinguished by. For the two electrons occupying the same orbital, values of n, l and ml are same. These three are same, but coming to ms, that is spin quantum number, that must be different. That is spin quantum number, you know that both two opposite spins are arranged in that, so that must be plus half and minus half. So the distinguished quantum number must be second option, that spin quantum number. Okay, students, is it clear? Let's start the next question. Which is the correct order of increasing energy of the listed orbitals in the atom of titanium? Titanium, they have given the atomic number 22 here. Let us see. 4s, 3s, 3p, 3d. 3s, 3p, 3d, 4s. 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d. And 3s, 4s, 3p, 3d. In this, basing upon the Euler chart, we can say this answer. For titanium, atomic number 22, they have given here. For this, basing on the Euler chart, if you write the electronic configuration, students, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6 and 4s2, 3d2. If you count these numbers, you should get the number 22, right? Okay, and order of increasing energy here, 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d. 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d. This is the order of increasing energy. So 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, that option C is correct. And next question, very very interesting topic. The number of d electrons in Fe plus 2 ion is not equals to the number of electrons in which of the following. So we have to calculate for this. How many number of electrons are present in Fe 2 plus ion? And from that we can separate only d electrons, and in which of the following those electrons not equal to which of the following they have asked the question. So for these atomic numbers they have given in the options itself. Let's start. C for iron, Fe atomic number 26 they have given. If I write the electronic configuration for this, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d6. This is the electronic configuration for iron 26. And students, if you write Fe2 plus electronic configuration, you need to remove these outermost electrons, 4s2. Okay? And for this, 4s0 you should get for Fe plus 2. And in this, what are the d orbital electrons? Let us see. D orbital electrons, those are 6 electrons. 6 electrons are present in only d orbital for Fe plus 2. And that is about option A. And if you write same like that only for option B. Option B what students? Only p electrons in neon. Neon, only p electrons we have to calculate for neon atomic number 10. And if you write the electronic configuration for this, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Here, only for the p orbital electrons are 6 electrons. So, these 6 equal. And if you see the option C for magnesium, magnesium s electrons in magnesium. So, atomic number 12 they have given in this 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s2. In these s electrons if you add, that means 1s electron, 2s, and if you add these you should get the number 6 here. These also 6 electrons. And option D, p electrons in chlorine. Chlorine atomic number 17, and if you write the electronic configuration for this, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2 and 3p5. And if you see the only p electron present in this, 6 plus 5, those are 11 electrons. So, which option is correct here? Number of electrons in Fe2 plus is not equal to the number of electrons of chlorine. P electrons of the chlorine is correct answer. So, option D is right. And see, let's start the next question, students. That is the last question of our today's session. The angular momentum of the electron in d orbital is equal to options 2 root 3h, 0h, root 6h and root 2h. For the angular momentum, the formula L into L plus 1 h. This is the formula. And here d orbital they have given. For the d orbital L value is 2. And if you substitute this L value in this formula, you can get root 2 into 2 plus 1 h is equal to root 2 into 3 h, and that is root 6 h. And the answer is option C. The angular momentum of electron in d orbital is equals to root 6 h. Okay students, I hope you understand this class. What we have learned in this class, students, all the 10 sums. First one, basing upon the Euler chart, and the second one is basing upon the transitions of the spectrum, the Lehmann series, bracket series and orbital angular momentum nodes, about the de Broglie's wavelength, and which one is the wrong statement explained, and present of electrons of the p orbital and spin, quantum numbers and the titanium electronic configuration. And students, last one, Fe plus 2 ion electrons we find out, angular momentum finally. Okay students, this is about our today's session, some solved examples from chemistry atomic structure. I have explained only 10 questions in this class students, and with some more examples, with some more solved examples, I'll meet you in my next class. If you understand this class, you can subscribe to this channel and share to your friends. And students, if you have any doubts and your views also, you can convey to me through the comment section. Please subscribe to this channel for my further updates. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.